Hi there, Neil Clark here from Falkirk Piping, www.falkirkpiping.com. Welcome to the channel. Videos contained here are designed as aid memoirs for my pupils, although they're free for anyone to use. If you're benefiting from the videos, please subscribe to the channel. This is completely free to do. May I also ask that you consider supporting my chosen charity, Parkinson's UK, by donating to my Just Giving page. The link to that page may be found in the comments box below this video. Today is Wednesday, the 27th of October, 2021, and it's day number 88. Rather a neat number on the Piping 100 Challenge. We're at Callendar House, here in Falkirk, which was originally owned by the Thanes of Callendar. The Thanes was a Scottish earl, there were seven of them, and the king was the High King, so these were all minor kings. Macbeth was a Thane, the Thane of Coder, and was actually a good guy. Shakespeare portrayed him as a bad guy because James VI's lineage came from Duncan. Anyway, originally owned by the Thanes of Callendar, but they were dispossessed because they supported Edward Balliol in the Wars of Scottish Independence, but Robert the Bruce actually came out on top. Passed over to the Livingston family, and eventually, during the industrial era, passed to the Forbes family, who produced this French Renaissance style chateau. There's an L-shaped tower house in there somewhere as well. It's built more or less on the line of the Antonine Wall, which is just over there. And we're going to go in and have a look. Mary Queen of Scots stayed here, Bonnie Prince Charlie stayed here, so did General Hawley, but he got beat. And we're going to go inside, we'll give you a tune. And what we'll try and do after that is we'll take loads and loads of photographs, we'll put some music to it, which can be obtained if you buy our CD. So Callendar House, still up and running. The Falkirk History Archives are based in here, and the place is run by Falkirk Community Trust, that have graciously allowed us to go and film in. So we'll go in now and have a tune. Hi there, well, we're inside now. I hope everything works out because we've got to do a bit of editing, but here's the drill. This is the Georgian kitchen within Callendar House. For those of you that are Outlander minded, you might recognise the kitchen. It was used in series 2 of Outlander, and we're led to believe from the staff this morning, because I haven't seen it, that the Duke of Sandringham met a grisly death in here, possibly at the hands of Jamie Fraser, although I couldn't speak for that. So, we'll tell you about the tunes then. First one is a Gaelic air, Cailinn, Ruinsa, just to give you a little bit of atmosphere. After that, we've got a Jacobite tune, it's the Roses of Prince Charlie, modern Jacobite tune, of course. And then we're going to finish with one, now you'll have seen the title, with Ye Jacobites by Name. It's an anti-Jacobite tune. We did some workshops in here, presenting Jacobite stuff for the primary 7 kids just before they went to high school, and they all thought it was a Jacobite tune. Listen to it. Ye Jacobites by Name, lend an ear, your doctrines I am on blame, let your schemes alone. Burns is saying, we've had enough of it. No more politicking and intriguing and geese peace. That's what he's saying. Anyway, we're going to go around the house after this and take a few photographs. I hope you enjoy looking around the place. There was loads more I'm supposed to say, and I've forgotten. So I'll put it all in the comment box below. And the tunes that you'll hear when we give you a little tour of the house, you can buy them on the Name Border CD available from us through the website, or just contact us here. Isn't this great? The staff put the fire on, especially for us. It's fantastic. Thank you.